Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome back. I appreciate you being here. So, 7 ways to save money on your next cruise. Number one, book early. So you gotta think about cruise lines like you would like booking a flight, okay? So a cruise line is like anything else, right? Whether it's Princess, Disney, it doesn't matter what line it is, right? They are all a business. They're in the business of making money, of course, right? So they like to entice people by the earlier you book, the better off you might get discounts and things like that. Things to make you really want to book that trip early, okay? So the earlier, the better, number one. Number two is this, book on the off season if you can. So what is the off season, right? What do you mean by off season, Mitch? Off season is January, May, late fall. Those are your off seasons. So if you know your destination, you know, like maybe the Caribbean might be nice in January. I don't know myself, but it might be nice in January, right? And so that might be a time where you want to book because ships, like cruise lines, like any business, want to keep the people coming to the ship so they can make money, right? And they already know January, May, and late fall are their lull times, right? So what better way to get those cabins filled than to offer cheaper prices, of course, right? That's how that always works, you know? So that's what you want to do. Number three is going to be this. Get the all-inclusive packages if you can. Now, you don't want to get ridiculous because by that I mean my wife and I, we don't drink. So we wouldn't get it all-inclusive with drinks, with alcohol drinks, right? We might get it with maybe the soda and the coffee, tea, whatever, right? But if you get to all-inclusive, therefore, you're not picked apart on the ship, you know, because you have everything there all for you, of course, all wrapped up in one nice, beautiful package. This point here, I want to tell you guys, thank you for subscribing. We're really growing nicely, you know, and I really appreciate this. This is a great community. It's really awesome. Yeah, we're tiny, but man, we're growing. We're growing so great. I'm so happy, you know, so let's keep on going with the growth, okay? Let's keep on going here. Okay, number four is kind of controversial. Just 2 weeks ago, some passengers missed their boat, missed the ship. The ship left without them, okay? So here's the saving money plan. You want to book excursions with the company you're on. Like if you're going to go Disney, you book a Disney excursion. If you want to go MSC, you book an MSC excursion. Now, we've been doing this for a few times. We have a couple people that we know on certain areas we go for excursions who they're not part of the company, right? But we know them as people we trust to get us here and there, back and forth, you know. So we don't use the ship's cruises, right? Tourists. We use our own touring company, okay? So, but for most people, if you don't have that kind of relationship, you really want to go with the cruise excursion company because this way they will guarantee the ship will not leave until you get back because they have to make sure if you book that excursion with the company, say you book it with Disney or Princess, whatever, they can't leave until they bring you back, right? It's a Disney force or whatever. It's through them. So they have to make sure you get to come back to the ship and it will not leave you alone. Okay. So that's how that works. So if you want that guarantee, book through them, of course. All right. Drum roll, please. Snacks. Now, I know this sounds funny, right? But I like to bring my own snacks, you know? So I'm a kind of a Trader Joe's kind of guy, you know, like the dry fruits and nuts and stuff like that, you know? Yeah, they have a lot of food on the ships for sure, you know? But let me give you my little personal story. When I take the... when I go on a cruise, guys, I tend to gain weight, you know? I gained 6 pounds last time, right? And the cruise before that, oh my gosh, I gained, right? So anyway, so I'm back to being disciplined again about my food and intake and stuff like that, you know. So what I do now, just a little hint for you, I'm not trying to give you guys any trying to health food advice, whatever, but all I do now before I go to eat dinner, lunch, whatever, I eat the fruit first and I drink a lot of water and then I go eat, right? So what I do then, like 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock at night, I get a little hungry, right? So I eat my snacks, my fruits and my nuts from Trader Joe's. That's what I do, right? So if you want to try to fight that gaining the weight crunch, you know, you got going on because you're on the cruise ship, bring some snacks for you. That's a good way to save some money too. Bring your own snacks, it'll be fine. I'd rather pay $4 at Trader Joe's than pay like $12 on the ship for the same product, right? So there we go, okay? One thing we really like are the onboard discounts. And here's what I do. The first day I get on the ship, right, we bring our luggage with us. And the guys, most of you guys don't know this, but we bring our luggage with us to our room because Our two cruises ago, they lost our luggage. So we were kind of, for about a whole day, my wife didn't have her luggage. Anyway, so now we bring it with us. So we bring our luggage with us, you know, and get to the room. And now we open up all the itineraries on the ship and we start booking things. You know, we look for discounts and stuff like that. There are so many discounts, you know. Real quick, I said it before, but the spa, right? You want to go to the spa, don't spend all that money on the spa. Wait until it goes into port, right? Our another secret here, wait the day before, right? Or the morning of, you know, go do those things you want to do at the spa. Same thing with the jewelry too. They will give away stuff. You know, I'm telling you, it's really good to go there when they're at port or when the day before you get off the day before you disembark, go down there and see what kind of discounts you can get for yourself, right? That's how you do that, you know? Take advantage of these discounts. So your first day there, I know you're excited. I know you want to get out to see the ship and all that stuff. It's great. But seriously, guys, look at the discounts while you're in that room because they are there, right? Last one I want to tell you about for save some money for yourself is to be flexible, right? By that, I mean, don't be so set in your ways as far as I'm going to go on this day here to this day here. I'm going to go to here. No, gotta be a little flexible because when you're flexible like that, you can save money. Airlines do it all the time, right? If you don't mind being a little flexible, you can save money on an airline. Maybe if you get bumped, you get money back that way. I mean, there's all sorts of ways. The ship industry, the cruise industry works the same exact way, you know? So just be flexible, all right? This is great. Oh, you guys, my Bobo people, I got an email back, two Bobos still. I'm so sorry, guys. I owe two Bobo watches still to people. I still got one. No one sent me their email to my email yet for their address. MitchesCityWalks@gmail.com. And I will email you. I will mail you, not email. I will mail you the Bobo watch, all right? 7 ways to save money on your next cruise. Take care, you guys.